Appreciate that. Liz, before you go.
Yeah.
I brought along two books that I had the pleasure and the privilege of publishing last year. And on behalf of Quinnipiac University. And it's celebrating the 250th anniversary of the St. Patrick's Day Parade in New York.
Nice.
Now remember, so the book is now about 2 years old. This is before the country was a nation. The Irish were walking up Broadway. And I think it's good to kind of remember that. And in fact, George Washington once said, "Who are those people?" And he put it to good use then, as we all know. But I would love you to take both copies of these books.
Thank you so much.
And please give them to the co-chairs. And anybody else would like a book, just give me your card and I'll make sure you get a book.
I will. So I will give this to Joe Crowley and Mario Diaz-Pilar.
Wonderful. I believe somebody is here from Joe Crowley's office.
Yes.
Oh, great. Good to see you. Crowley is our man.
Yeah.
He's so sorry you couldn't be here today. I think he had a family obligation.
Oops, sorry.
He had a family obligation today, but I know he would have really liked to.
Yeah, well, he's there when we need him. It's my privilege to be here this morning. I got a call from a great historian. She is actually the expert on the Great Hunger. Her name is Christine Keneally. And Christine is in England at the moment, and she had some minor surgery, couldn't make it back here, wanted to be here, and asked me if I would step in. I said, sure. And then I thought, oh my God, these are important people. But we'll give it a shot. And it really is it's a wonderful time for me to come and talk about this, because something kind of extraordinary is going on for me in terms of the period of the Great Hunger. And,